Yes.
Okay. Good evening. A warm welcome to all of you. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Singapore chapter, welcomes you all to our event today, Excel Business Intelligence. Today, we are going to talk about power. A powerful combination of power and power yet complement each other. Yes, it is MS Excel has this powerful combination of Power Query and Power Pivot. Power Query and Power Pivot complement each other to build robust BI within Excel. Power Query provides a powerful utility to import and connect external data, edit, transform, and shape data as needed. Power Pivot is a data modeling an analysis tool that works on the data as imported in Excel. Today, to explain on this, we have our member speaker, CA Kushal R. Jaju. He's a chartered accountant and BCom honors graduate from India. For the past 10 years, he has been working with multinational companies in leading FP&A and finance business partnering roles. He's passionate about his work and loves sharing his views on FP&A and, more importantly, MS Excel via LinkedIn and Instagram Reels. Many of our members have seen recently that he has been posting a lot of Excel tips in his LinkedIn. So before we start this, we would like to start with our ICA motto. The motto of the ICAI is Ya Eshu Supteshu Jagriti, which literally means a person who is awake in those that sleep. It is a quotation from the Upanishads. Kushal, can you please play that?
Yaesha Supteshu Jagrati. Yaesh Supteshu Jagrati Kamam 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 Kamamsho Purusho Nirvimanah Nirvimanah Tadeva Shukram Tadeva Shukra Brahma Tad Brahma Tadeva Amritamuchyate Tasmin lokah shatah sarvetaduna sarvetaschanatyati kaschan etat dvaita.
Thank you. Kushal, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kalamim. Hello, good evening and good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for being here. Today, the session is on Power Query and Power Pivot. In the next few hours, I think we'll cover about 2 hours together. We'll discuss on the features of Power Query. MS Excel is a tool we have been using for the data crunching and making dashboards, etc. But many of us do not use it as a business intelligence tool. So it can support us as a business intelligence tool and to get the work done by complex data modeling, etc., which we will talk about in the coming slides. So here, let me set the theme for today's discussion. I'll share this presentation with few concepts as well as what we are going to today and the objective for the session, and like that we will move ahead in our session. Prerequisite for this, as we have been circulating earlier, the Power Query and Power Pivot is supported by MS Excel version 2010 and beyond. But if you are using MS Excel 2010 or 2013, it need to be activated as an add-in. I hope all of you have activated the add-in If not, please scan this QR code, or you can also find the link in the chat window. Please follow the YouTube video to activate the add-in for Power Query as well as Power Pivot. Moving ahead, what is the objective for the today's session? In today's session, we will understand how to connect, load, and transform data from different data sources. We will introduce ourselves to Power Query Ribbon, what all are the menu options, and then understand some of the basic as well as advanced uses of the features available. We will also see how do we automatize the data loading as well as the steps that we will go through to develop our file. How do we automatize all those loading as well as steps on the new data point as and when we get. We will also introduce ourselves to Power Pivot, data management, and data modeling. Before we go into the session, I would like to show you this picture. If you know how to drive a car, I want you to remember or recall the first day when you entered into your learning school, the learning school for driving. It would have been overwhelming for you to see there are a lot of things to take care of. There is a steering, there is clutch, brake, gear, rear view mirror, side view mirror. Then you have to take care of what is the size of your car, length and width and everything. It would have been overwhelming. You would have thought, oh, come on, I cannot drive the car. But today you can drive your car. And you know, it's not overwhelming. It's about practice. You put your driving skills into practice and you are a good driver today. And that's what we need for anything that we learn. And same goes with the Power Query. Another point, in the day one, the first day of your learning class, did you learn everything how to drive a car? No, because that was the day when you get exposed to the basics as well as some of the advanced stages. But as you go into your learning stage, you get expert into that. Before we go into practicality of what is data modeling and what are the different tables and the keys that we are going to use, I want to show you a little bit on the theory side. But for us to understand what are the different type of tables that we will refer in the session that ahead of us, and then what all are the keys that connects all those different tables. On the left side, you will see the dimension table. What is dimension table? Dimensions are where you have a complete details. In short, or to easily understand, we can say customer master data, product master data, supplier master data. These are the dimensions which are detailed, descriptive, and which are one source of your information. Sounds right? Also, you have a unique value. For an example, your customer number, your supplier code number, your customer code number, customer account number, all those are unique. That doesn't get repeated. So the dimension are the detailed information about and one source of information. And you have a one unique key, one unique, which identifies the table across all different tables. And that is known as primary key. If you see on the table this side, for an example, item table, which is a dimension table, item key is a primary key. It doesn't repeat, right? Your SKU code, your item code is only one for one product. And that is called your primary key. Similarly for branch, location, time, or it could be even your customer, supplier, etc. That is this data modeling structure that you see, it is called as star schema. So all the dimension table are on the edge of the star. In the middle is your fact table. What is your fact? The fact is your actual sales, actual purchases. For an example, you might sell to one customer 10 times a month, right? There could be 10 invoices to the same customer code. So the customer code can be repetitive in fact table, right? And that is why it is known as foreign key. So what do we do essentially? We connect those primary key from the dimension table to foreign key of the fact table. Why do we do this? To avoid redundancy, to maintain one source of information. And because you are not duplicating the columns, it reduces the file size and thereby the processing power really increases, trust me. About me, slightly background, Kala ma'am has already introduced me, so thank you very much. Kalamem. So if you want to follow me on LinkedIn or Instagram, where I share FP&A and MS Excel tips, you can scan the QR codes for LinkedIn as well as for Instagram. Moving ahead, let's dive in this session. Give me a moment and I will share my file. If you have, I believe everyone has access to the exercise files that were shared earlier. If not, I can quickly share the link for you to download the file, because that is where we are going to work together and we need to make it as an interactive session. So please do download the file and I send the link to you in the chat window. Moving ahead, in that file you would have seen there are a lot of different tables or different Excel files. I consolidated here to show you the power of Power Query and Power Pivot combination. You would see there is one file called 2018 transactions, where we have transaction date, we have product ID, customer ID, store ID, as well as quantity. So that is what we have, the sales data, very short sales data. It doesn't duplicate any of the column. But suppose your boss or the management wants you to show you by customer category what is the sales, or maybe they want you to show you the sales by region, or they might ask you to show you the sales by different product categories or by different stores, etc. In the normal scenario, if you're not using Power Query or what I have been doing earlier, I would create a lot of different columns. I would call, if you want me to do region, what I would do, I would VLOOKUP the store ID, right? I would do this VLOOKUP into region lookup. Okay, and then I come to know, oh, there is no store ID here. So there is no common source. What I have to do? I have to go to store lookup and I have to somehow find all the store IDs and region ID. And I have to do, you know, a lot of concatenate to get store ID in the region here. And then by that store ID, I move to region, a lot of VLOOKUP. And what does it mean? It means if your file size is bigger, you keep on increasing the file size and then it doesn't serve your purpose. Today, the management may want you to give the file based on to store. Tomorrow, they may ask you on the product. So what you do? Again, the same we look up on the product, right? And then it's keep on happening. And at the end of the day, if you think about your productivity, you would think, oh, come on, it's a lot of we look up. Why cannot IT give all the columns in the sales data itself, right? But does this make you productive or efficient? Probably no, because then the file size is bigger and the processing time is lower. What we can do? That is where the power of Power BI comes into picture. That is the business intelligence. If you do not have access to Tableau or Power BI, never mind. The Power BI helps you do the same, almost not the same thing, but to a large extent in the same, it gives you the same power of business intelligence. So how do we do that? Let's go to how do we build the similar. So to show you what we can build in the same table that we were seeing earlier, if you want to create dashboards, we can create a dashboard like this, which is by timeline. So you can easily choose which month you want to see the data for different type of stores and into different regions. For which year and for which month, you can easily change the year here, whether you want 2018 half year or you want 2018 full year, whether you want for any of the quarter, or even more, you can see the data by each of the month. What are the numbers for 2018? And the good thing is once you click on April, it changes everything. And that is the slicing and dicing. How can we do this slicer without using a VLOOKUP in the same table? That's what we are going to see. And if you see the numbers here, if you put a little bit focus, once I change the number here, it changes all the tables. And all of this we can do by Power Query. How do we bring the data into the Power Query? That's an important point. And that's the starting point, right? How do we do this? For you, everyone, the Power Query is known in this version, because the Power Query was the word which was, I think, in 2010 and 2013. But is the Excel keep on updating their version? The Power Query now known as get and transform data, as you can see here. The get and transform data, if you are using MS Excel 2010 or 2013, and you would have activated the tabs by following the video link that we have shared earlier, you would see Power Query and Power Pivot as a separate menu bar on the top. But if you are using MS Excel 2016 and beyond, you will see the Power Query feature under data, get and transform data. All right. If everyone is okay, are able to see where do we have get and transform data, give a thumbs up on the Zoom.
Sorry, can I interrupt? Kushal, we are still seeing that Excel sheet only. Yeah, are you changing the to another tab?
They want to see the data. Can you go to the data and show them the power?
Yeah, my bad. Let me share my whole screen. Is it better now? Can you
see? Yes, yes, we can see the get and transform data. And also, Kushal, can you tell one more time which file you're sharing now? Because somebody asked which is the file you're using now.
Yeah, as of now, so now I'll be using the files. As of now, I'm not using any file. Now we will be working together to bring all those different files into Power Query.
Okay, okay.
The file earlier was just an example we can achieve, right? Okay. So now we will build a similar using Power Query without using VLOOKUP.
Sure.
You can see the data tab. Under data tab on the left side, you will see get and transform data. If you click on get data, and if you are into MS Excel 2010 or 13, you will see on the top ribbon here, and you will see similar feature get data. Once you click on get data, you have a lot of options. You can bring any file, which is Excel file. It could be comma separated value or TXT file. It could be XML or PDF, or you can also bring or get data from the full folder. If you have 10 files in a folder, you get 10 files in here. You can also get it from the database like SQL or Access or Azure, or if you have any other sources, like it could be from the web or all the different options that MS Excel supports. For now, because we know the Excel files, let me also show you the folder. You would have received this folder, shared files. When you click on this, you will see there is one transaction folder and there are some lookup files. There are return file, there is transaction 2019, and there is one sample text file. So these files, if you do not have, please download from the link shared in the chat. Moving on, get data from file, and all these files, as you can see, the type is comma separated value. So we are going to bring get data from file comma separated value. Let's bring, for an example, customer lookup data. So now click on import. It will take a few seconds to get the data. So here you can see the file origin. Generally, we do not change this file origin because it's automated. Then you have delimiter. Delimiter basically defines the different columnar into data. For an example, if I select, semicolon, I get all the information in only one column. So here we know that delimiter is comma, we select comma. Then there is data type detection. The Power Query can automatically detect your data type, whether it is a number or text, or it could be any other that we will see. You can load your file as it is into the file, or you click on transform data to open the Power Query. It will take another few seconds before it opens up based on the number of rows you have in your data. Okay, so that's the file we see. On the right side, query setting, you will see the name of the file, and then there are a few steps that has already been applied. The source of the file. So as you can see, what I'm highlighting, what is the source of this file? Then there is already a few steps applied, because the file, if you see initially, if I click there, there was no file name. So for an example, let's remove this step so that we can do, I will remove this step, and like that, we can do all these steps by ourselves. and I change this as well. So this is the data we have. There are a few tabs on the top. You would see there's a home tab, transform, add column, and view. The home tab is basically gives you different options that you can apply on your table, on your data. Transform is more or less specific to any of the column that you are going to select and then transform the data within the column. Add column will create another column within the same data. And then view is basically another few dimensions. So let's see the data that we have imported. What we see that the column headers are, the table headers are column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so which are not right. And we see the actual header is here in the row number 1. Go to home where we see...
Kushal, sorry. I think members are asking to repeat this. Can you just request you to repeat this, what you told?
Yeah. Sorry. So you want me to import the data again? Let me import the data again, maybe. Okay. Okay, so we will import the data again. It is the Power Query import data option is under data, get data. Click on from file, from text and CSV. And as of now, I'm selecting customer lookup data. You can also import customer lookup data. Give Excel a few seconds to analyze the data we are importing. There you go. You see the table already identified by the different column and then data type detection. So I'm clicking on do not detect data type. And like that, or you can also choose based on the first 200 rows based upon how you want. And I'll click on transform data to open the Power Query window. And there you go. You get the file. This is Power Query Editor is what we call. You would see there is a home button. There are a home ribbon, transform, add column, as well as view. Home is where you have a few options or features to transform the table. Transform column works more or less for a specific column. Then we have add column to add any new column we want to add within the same table. And view is different type of viewing. We want to see column distribution, the size or profile, etc. First of all, when we see the table, we see the column headings are not proper because heading is supposed to be the customer ID. And that's where it's a very good feature of Power Pivot, Power Query. You click on use first row as headers and you will see under the home tab. Once I click this, the first row becomes the header. And you will see on the right side, you will see one step applied promoted headers. So the header has been promoted already. And the next type you will see change type. That means the type has already been identified for each of the column. What is the data type? You will see on the left side of the column name. For the name, this is the text column, which is already identified. Customer account number is, as you can see, is a whole number. Then last name, customer address, customer city, and all the columns are there for customer postal code. All the data types, column types are already identified. And if you want, you can also change it. For an example, the customer account number, and we want customer account node as a number because we are not going to perform any summation or addition, any statistical functions. We can also convert it into text. And then it will get converted into the text. So depends upon the type of data. If the column type is not correctly identified, we can change the column type by selecting the top left button. So until this, I think I will stop for a minute. And I want everyone to follow the same steps so that you know, we can do this together and we do not miss any steps. Can I request everyone to please follow the similar for 1 minute? And then we continue.
Kushal, Pratima, yes. Here.
Yes, Pratima.
In my sheet, I am not able to see the text type, like the 1, 2, 3 or the ABC, the type of data.
I'm not able to see in my file. So is that okay?
What is the heading name?
I automatically got the first line as the header. So I didn't even get that other one which you deleted in your file. I just got the exact customer ID, but it's just that on the on your sheet, I can see there's a small 1, 2, and 3 and the A, B, C, which indicates the type of data in the column. That is not present in my file.
It doesn't matter. You can click and you can actually choose the data. You can change the data type because it depends upon the setting. If I could show you the setting, but there's a setting, probably your setting is...
okay, no problem. So that's not so important, right?
Not so important, yeah.
All right, thank you.
There's a setting button where you can check or uncheck if you want to auto detect the type of column. Okay, so let's do a few things on the column here. So we know we have customer account number, first name, last name, we have address, city, province, then we have customer postal code, country, birth date, marital status, income, we have gender, total children or children at home, education, as well as a few information. Let's say we want to create one column to have first name and last name together. So as I said, if you want to transform the same column, you need to use transform tab. But if you want to create another column, you need to click on add column, right? So how do we do? Select these two columns. Or you can also do from here, right? Either you can do merge column. And if you do merge column, it can merge. If I click on merge column and you would see, just give a few seconds. And it tells you what is the separator you are going to use. Let's say we are going to use the space and the new, let's say we call it full name, the new column name, and then I click OK. And you will see at the end, I get the full name. This we used by doing this add column. So add column adds the data into your file. And you would see this is coming from first name and last name, and it added the column. You can, on the right side, you can see inserted merged column. So like that, you can apply different type of functions that you want to apply on your data table. And we will go a little bit more, but also considering the time that we have, click on the file, close and load to. There are a few options in close and load to. Don't click on close and load, but click on close and load to. You will get a few options. If you want to bring this as a table in your Excel file, if you want to create a pivot table out of this, or you want to create a pivot chart, or you only want to create a connection. And that's where the BI part comes into picture. You can create connections by keeping the source file as it is there. And then you click on add this data to data model. So you click on only create connection, and add this data to the data model. You do this and you click OK. On the right side, you would see the customer lookup table is there.
Sorry, Kushal, can you just repeat that last point? I was just looking at just that.
Yeah.
Add this data to the data model just before that.
Yeah, so you create, you click on, select the create connection. I'll show you the window again. Click on only create connection and check the box which reads add this data to the data model.
Okay, yeah, got it. Thanks.
And click OK. You would see the table appearing on the right side under queries and connection window. And the number of rows that it will.
Number of rows added.
Yeah, perfect. So like that, we will bring a few more tables and then we will see the next step. So I'm going back to Power Query. You can also, if you are into Power Query Editor, click on New Source, File, CSV, and let's bring a few more tables within the data table.
Kushal, just one question. So initially, the sample.txt which you took, I'm unable to open it in Notepad. It is too huge. Just wanted to understand, is that a comma separated file?
No, sample text file is not comma, comma separated. No, that's a text document. It should actually open into a Notepad.
No, that is fine. I'm trying to understand is when you did that get data, you got you selected comma as a separation indicator, right?
That because the file that I imported was customer lookup, and that customer lookup table is comma separated value.
Okay, you and imported okay, fine. In that case, it's fine. Thank you.
Yeah, and that's the comma separated value file. Yeah.
Okay.
And
like so basically, the delimiter which we use if the file which we are importing is comma separated, then are you suggesting the delimiter which we use also should be a comma?
Exactly.
Or we can use a pipe or something else.
So let me show you. For an example, I'm importing the product lookup file now, which is again a comma separated value.
Okay.
So here you would see it's already delimiter is already selected by Excel by identifying the data that it's a comma. If you change it to anything, for an example, colon, you will not see all the columns.
Correct.
Your data is into one column. So you need to select comma because it's in CSV file. And that's how you see all the information. So you get the data and you just need to click OK and you get this file. On the left-hand side, you would see the product lookup appearing.
Okay.
And like that, can everyone please bring all the files into the Power Query window by following the same procedure, new source file, text CSV, and bring all the lookup files. Once the files are here, we will see how do we edit or modify any of the columns again, if we need it.
Sorry, Kushal, can we get all, like select all files and get them at once or need to do it one by one?
We need to do one by one. There's another way where you can get that by selecting the folder. But as of now, I suggest to get one by one because jumping to folder would be a bit early. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
Are we uploading only the first 200 rows or the entire data set?
Entire data set. The first 200 rows on the dialog box that you see is only to identify the data type.
Okay, so we select based on entire data set.
You can do that, but generally basically what you have in first 200 rows are the same data for rest of the rows also. So you can choose to select 200. If you choose based on entire data set, it will take a little bit more time to import the data.
Okay.
So, Kushal, when we are taking the data from the file, there are two buttons. One says load and one says transform data.
Yes.
You have been clicking on the load button, right?
So let me close this because I was importing within the Power Query. So I was clicking on the load, but ideally you should click on transform data. So you click on get data again. Let me show you after this processing.
Get data,
click on
and
modify.
Then transform data button.
Yes, and then you should click on transform data.
Okay. Thank you.
Just a minute.
Mr. Kushal, actually, I am not able to see the screen in my Excel in the way you are getting it in your screen.
Can I ask you to go to the file window, the file menu, and go to the account option and tell me the MS Excel version that you are using?
I am actually using Microsoft Excel 2016.
Then ideally, you should get it under data tab. You should have this option under the data tab. Under the data tab, you should have get and transform. It is known as get and transform.
Yeah, it is there as get and transform tab, but it is showing new query, show queries from table and all that.
Do you also have a get data button there?
There is no get data actually. There is an external get external data, but that is grayed out actually.
If you click on get external data, what does it say?
No, it is. I'm not able to click on that. It is actually grayed out.
Very much sure, because ideally it should, until you have deactivated, no, but ideally if you see the data here, you should get get and transform also.
I am getting get and transform. But
okay.
That, do you want me to just share my screen if possible?
I'm not sure if it is if it is activated for known host to share. But do you have a search window on the top? I think you have a search window on the top, right? On the top, do you have a search window in 2016?
Search window.
There is a search icon on the top where you can click get data.
So basically, where you see the top bar of Excel, to the right, you will see a blank area where you can type. That is the search window.
Okay, tell me what you want to do. Okay.
Type something over there. Type get data over there.
Okay. Okay, get data. When you type on that, it says from file, from workbook, from CSV, from XML, like that.
From CSV.
So click on here.
Okay, and then we have to just import all the other files, is it?
Yeah, all the lookup files, yeah.
But my Microsoft Excel version is not the original version. It is not. It says product activation failed. Could it be because of that, that some of the functions are not there or something like that?
Could be. I'm not an expert into that, but it could be the reason. If it is not an genuine like MS Excel without activation, it could be the reason.
Okay, thank you.
So continuing, so we have brought customer, product, region, and store. So someone asked which button do we click. So I'll import another lookup table, which one I have not brought in. Okay, maybe calendar lookup. I click on import. And I'm clicking on the transform data, right? It will open the query editor. All the files are there. Once you import, on the right side, you will see the table name, which is calendar lookup. You will see a few steps like source, then promoted headers or change data type. So we have imported so far 5 lookup tables. I hope everyone has done the same at their site. In the customer lookup table, we inserted one column by using add column functionality. We selected this first name and last name. We selected both the columns by using a shift button. And then we click on merge column. And we can insert another column with the full name at the end of the table, extreme right side. Similarly, when we go to, for an example, product lookup table, we see that product retail price is identified as a decimal number. If we want, we can convert it into currency and it will show you the column as in currency value. So now it's into currency, as you can see on the top. So it's into dollar currency. Similarly, product cost, product weight, recyclable, all these columns. So it depends upon the type of data that you have, right? What is null for Power Query? The zero means null. If there is no data, it is known as null. So it's a bit different than Excel, right? In Excel, you saw the blank column, but in Power Query, you will not see the blank column or blank cell. You will see the null value. Null means it's blank in Power Query.
So well, I'm far, sorry, can you please show how to add that again, the first name and the last name? Can you please show it once again?
Yeah, so let me delete the step that we did earlier. So what you need to do, click on first name and then press the control button and select the last name. And like this, you have highlighted first name and last name. You go to add column. In add column, you will see one option known as merge column. You find the column, the feature merge column, right?
Yes.
So click on merge column, it will ask you a few options. What is the delimiter you want to use? So separator, let's say we want to use a space. to first name space last name, and then what is the new column name? Let's call it full name and click OK. Once you click OK, on the right side, you will see one step applied, inserted merge column. And on the right side, if you go on the table, you will see the full name column appearing there.
OK, got it. Thank you.
OK, so like this,
actually,
now let's
when talk- I, just one question. When I did that, the full name column has appeared right at the beginning of the table. And the first name, last name columns have disappeared.
Yeah, because what you would have done, you would have clicked the merge within the transform tab. If you click, okay, for an example, I'll show you. If I click transform, if I click on the merge column within the transform, it will not add a new column, but it will merge these two columns. But if you go to add column and then click on merge column, it will insert a new column.
Okay, okay.
And there is no control Z here. So basically what you can do on the right side, you need to delete that step, and by deleting that step, you will get back the data in the earlier way.
Okay, got it.
And then you again select both, but this time you go to add column and merge column. And that's why it is important, because you will see the similar kind of features available within transform as well as add column. So we need to remember transform transforms the same column, and add column creates another column, keeping the base column as it is.
Got it. Thank you.
Okay. So with this, we have a few columns. Now, how about the different features that are available? We will speak about the different features also in another Excel file, because in this probably you do not have a lot of changes to be done. But what I can show you, for an example, you want to delete a few columns on the top. You can click on remove row, remove top row, and you can select how many rows you want to delete. And like that, you can delete a lot of rows. You want to keep row, you want to remove any of the column. For an example, I don't need customer account number, for an example. I click on remove column and I can remove it. So the column of the customer account number, I have removed it. And like that, I can do a few different type of data crunching or data modification. We can also do, for an example, if you want to do a grouping of, let's say if I go to product lookup data, and actually it will work only in the value data. So once we see the transaction file, we can also group data by a common grouping to group all the data for multiple rows. We can reduce the number of rows. Transform, you can transpose. There's another very interesting topic I will try to cover. How do we use the transpose, unpivot, and pivot columns? There is a split column. Now, that is also very important. So for an example, you have a product name, or let's go to customer lookup column again. And because this is what we created, right? We have the full name here. And if you want to split this full name into separate two columns, first name and last name, how do we do that? So that also you can do by selecting full name, go to add column, click on extract, and you can do text before delimiter, text after delimiter, text between delimiter. What is that? Let's say text before delimiter. It's similarly what we do into Excel by using left feature. Let's say the delimiter here is what, space, right? So we do a space here, and I click OK. You would see it has extracted the text before the delimiter. That means the first name. And all of these things you can do into the data that you have. And if you want to split this column, full name, click on split column by delimiter, again, similar way. And that's the space, each occurrence. And there are a few options, like what is the delimiter space and which one you want to use. There could be 5 or 6 space in the same file, same column sometimes. So you can choose which you want, leftmost, rightmost, or each occurrence. Let's use each occurrence for now and click OK. You would see there are 2 new columns available now. Full name and last name. it has modified the existing version with full name and last name. Wherever the name could be into, for an example, the name would somewhere there were two spaces. So all the third column, you will see null value, but there could be somewhere where they have first name, middle name, and last name. And then you can change the name, column names here. I'm deleting the step because we do not need that. We also do not need to split the columns. So far, what we have done is imported 5 lookup tables within the Power Query. And we have seen a few of the functions that we can use on the different columns. So far, if everything is clear, if any questions so far. Okay, another file I would want you to import now is the transactions data. So go to shared file, go to transactions, the file that I shared, and click on transactions 2018. Once you click that, you will get all the transactions details of 2018. Again, similar because it's a CSV file, comma separated value files. Your delimiter is comma. Based on the first 200 rows, you can see the data and you click OK. Because I'm importing when I'm in Power Query already, so I'm clicking on OK. But if you are doing it from outside, get and transform data, you should click on transform data or edit data. And you get this transaction date and you would see that the column type is already identified as a date. Then you have product ID, customer ID, store ID, and the quantity. For now, we will keep this. If you will click on close and load arrow button, do not click on close and load icon, but click on close and load arrow and click on close and load 2. And then select only create connection and add this to the data model and click OK. And like that, we have brought all those two or three files that we were working since the last import. On the right side, you will see all the data. If there is any error, you will also see an error message on the right. If you just hover on the file, you can see the type of data which is inside. If you just hover on any of the data. So far, if everything is clear.
I have brought in some extra files also. I think by mistake I took the text file also, and I mean originally. So how to delete those? Should I delete those or should I just bring everything?
It's okay. Even if you brought in, it's fine. Otherwise, once you are here, just right click and click on delete, and you can delete that query.
Okay. Yeah.
Can you just repeat the last step? How did you get into Excel? How did you close and get into Excel, please?
Yeah. So I'll go back to the file, the Power Query editor. So on the left hand side, when you are in the home button, you would see an option of close and load. So do not click on the icon there, but click on close and load arrow. Okay. And there you will have a close and load to option. As of now, it is grayed out because I have already done it. But for you, you will see close and load 2. Once you click close and load 2, you would see a feature, a dialog box, what we were seeing earlier. Let me show you again. You will see a dialog box something like this. You need to click on only create connection and add this data to the data model.
Well, in my sheet, only create is not only create connection is not activated in my worksheet. What could be the reason?
If you already do you see the data in the table? Did you open a new file or you are working in any of the existing lookup files? Are you working in any of the lookup files or you created a new file to work on this plan, the activities that
I'm not sure. I initially I just opened whatever you sent, right?
Okay, yeah.
So initially I just opened those files, and then I think it's in customer lookup. Yes, I think the original file, customer lookup, first file what I had. So in that only all these files got loaded.
Okay. And the issue that you have where you do not find that option is only for that table or for all the tables? Like for customer lookup table, you are not getting that option of create connection, but about other files, you are getting that option, right?
Not sure actually. But
if you can try, did you import other files into the Power Query already?
1 minute. I lost that file. Too many files open here. I'll just come back to you. Yeah.
Hi, Kushal. If there is some errors, how to resolve the error? Because I can see in my screen the transaction 2018 has some error.
So what is the error? Error is in Power Query or after you imported?
After I imported.
Hello.
Can you read for me the error message that you are getting?
Hello.
Yes.
I cannot see any error message, but it is showing that 52 row error, something like that.
Can you just close or maybe do not import and try to import again the transaction 2018 file, if you can import again.
Okay, and so try to re-import.
Yeah, ideally, because if you click on the right options, generally it should not appear because you are only importing and which is a simple process, so there shouldn't be any error as such.
So shall I need to delete this from the query or?
Yeah, what you can do on the left side, you can right click and delete the query and then re-import the table.
Okay, thank you.
In the meantime, let's do a little bit of another activity to add a column, where you want to add a column which could be conditional. You remember we use if statement in MS Excel, right? If this, then this, like that, if you want to import some columns, what we can use. Okay, we have this member card here. So what all are the options? We have an options of bronze, golden, normal, and silver. Can we define that, for an example, the golden and silver for us are the priority customers, and normal is more or less, let's say, opportunity customer, and bronze could be the least priority customer, something like that. Can we insert a column? We need to go to add column. Okay. Select the member card, go to conditional column. Under add column, click on conditional column. Why I'm showing you this is, again, in Excel, if you could add if statement, here also it supports you to add the if statement. The new column name, let's call it customer priority. And if column name, we need to select the member card. So let's say if member card equals, gold, then the output could be priority. Then add close again. If member card equals, we saw silver. And then also let's call it priority. And another add code close, same member card equals, normal. And we call it opportunity. Or otherwise, if none of these three matches, else let's call low priority. Makes sense, right? We have been doing such kind of activities within MS Excel with all the if statements, right? If member card equals gold, we call it priority in the new column. If it is silver, we call it priority. If it is normal, we call it opportunity. Otherwise, we call it low priority. And you click OK. On the right side, you will see a column has been inserted with all the if statement that we just now wrote. And you could see the bronze, this is bronze, which is as low priority. And for an example, this silver is on priority. So all this kind of actions we can actually do on the file. If I want to know how many customers we have, just click on any column, go to standard, go to home tab, transform tab status, and then click on count values. And it will tell you how many number of customers you have. So 10,000. Anyway, I'm going to delete this for now to go back to the original table. Okay, I will do, okay, it's already close and load, so I'll just close. So far, everything is okay. You are with me, right?
How did you go back to Excel?
I just clicked on close and load.
Okay.
Kushal, could you please repeat how to do that?
Yeah. I go back to the query editor.
For me, I have all the files on separate sheet and I'm stuck there.
On the separate sheets, right? Because yes. You would have clicked directly close and load and you would have imported them as a table.
It's on separate sheets and as a table and separate, I mean, same file, separate sheets.
I know, because same file on separate sheets or the different files, right?
Separate.
For example, if I do customer lookup table, if I click on load to, and if I click on the table, it will insert another sheet for me to import this table within my Excel file. But if I click on only create connection, then it will not import the table in this sheet. You get what I mean, right? For example, I click on the table. And once I click on the table, I can see the customer lookup table is actually now as part of my Excel sheet. And you would see here in a few minutes here. Because I imported as a table. But if I go back and change it to only create connection and add this to the data model and I click OK, it will ask me that, do you want to remove it? I say yes. And it will again get deleted from my table, from my sheet, and it will only create a connection. Okay. Now, what do we do? We have all the tables, but how do we get to what we wanted to do without doing VLOOKUP? That's where the part of Power Pivot comes into picture. You would find Power Pivot again as an add-in or as a separate tab on top of your MS Excel ribbon. If everyone is able to see the Power Pivot option or the menu bar on the top.
No, I don't have Power Pivot.
Which is the Excel version? Okay, what you can do for everyone, let's follow this step. And just to see if you have gotten it activated, you need to go to File menu. On the File menu, you need to go to Options. Then you click on Add-ins. In the Add-ins, you will see Manage. Click on Comb Add-ins. So if anyone is not able to see the Power Pivot, follow the steps so far. Go to File window, the File menu, click on Options. In the left side of that dialog box, click on Add-ins. In that Add-ins, in under the Manage Add-ins, in the dropdown, please select Comb Add-ins. I'll wait for a few seconds. And then click on Go. There you would see in the new dialog box, you would see the Power Pivot for Excel appearing. Just check the checkbox before that and click OK. And you would see this as a separate ribbon on the top of your Excel.
Got it.
Okay, everyone is with me. Can we move ahead to Power Pivot to really see the how do we do the data modeling? Everyone is with me? Okay, I see. Yes, great, thank you. On the Power Pivot, you have a few options. The Manage, which is data modeling management. Then there are measures. There are KPIs. There is an option of Add to Data Model. We will look We will speak about it later if time permits. But more or less, as of now, we need to click on this green button, which is data manage. Under the data model, you will see the manage. Click on the manage, and you would see all those tables right in front of you under the Power Pivot data modeling management. You would see if you have imported all the files as I have done, you would see similar customer lookup, store lookup, product lookup, region lookup, calendar lookup, and transaction 2018. Just go and on the right side under the home tab, you will see diagram view. Click on the diagram view. And you would see all the files there in front of you as a tabular with all the column headings. While I was learning Power Query, the one very important tip that my trainer gave me that keep all the lookup tables on the top and keep all lookup tables mean your dimension tables, right? Keep all dimension tables on the top and keep all your fact table on the bottom. This is how you should manage is what my trainer told me. You could also do it as a star schema, which we saw earlier, right? Keep the fact table in the front. Yeah.
I after clicking on manage data, Power Pivot for Excel file has come up. After that, I lost it. What do I have to do?
So once you click on the manage, yes, you would see this screen, all the data, right?
No, this has not come.
So what do you see in your screen?
New file pop-up has come, which says Power Pivot for Excel. And some icons are, I can see clipboard, get external data, sort and filter, and all those options are there, formatting.
You have to do, when you click on this data management, you have to do in the same file where you built all the queries.
Yes, I did there itself.
Does anyone else also getting the same issue in the Power Pivot?
Yes, I'm also getting the same thing.
Then we are getting options like get external data from database, again the same things.
Do you have any option where you can select? You have not clicked on pivot table or pivot chart, right? In the Power Pivot, you are clicking on the manage. And do you get an option of using a data model of this file?
No, see, after I click on manage button, directly another window opens, another file, mm-hmm. which says it looks similar to, there is no grid lines, but maybe it's an Excel file or I don't know what this file is. It has options like file, home, design, advanced.
Design, advanced, yes. The same options that I see. So can you click, can you try clicking on the refresh button under the home tab?
Refresh button is grayed out, but there is clipboard and get external data options.
And if you click on get external data, do you get any option of using data model?
From database, from data service, from other sources, existing connections.
Can you see, okay, click on existing connections.
I did. Another pop-up comes in, which says select an existing connection.
Can you go back to your query window, click on load to, and can you confirm me you have checked this button, add this data to the data model?
Okay. So I go back.
It may be that you have only created connection, but you have not added the data to the data model.
Okay, so I go back to launch Power Query.
Just click on the right side here. Just on the right side, you on the table right side, you do a right click and go to load to. And there you can see what you have selected. And you can also see, Ms. Rajal, do you also... because you are also getting the same issue, right? If I understood it correctly. So just try to click on right, just do a right click on load to, and see if you have selected add this data to the data.
Right click and then click on?
Load to.
Load to. Yeah, I have clicked on add this data to data model. Yes.
Yeah, that's right. So
I am getting this. This query is currently connected to tables, pivot tables, charts, or calculations in your workbook. Removing it from model.
No, you don't need to remove. You need to check it. You don't need to uncheck it.
So for each of them, you have to go and click that?
Yeah, if you have not clicked earlier, you have to do it for every table. Every file, when you load, you should load it. If you import any new file or any sheet into your Power Query data model, you should click on only create connection and then add this to the data model. Because if you don't add it to data model, you cannot utilize the relationship and the data modeling that we will talk about.
Clear. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Kushal.
No problem, Mr. Iqbal. Please, everyone, please also do the same. If you have not done it, I'll pause for a minute so that you can right-click, go to load to, make sure you have selected only create connection and you have added this data to the data model. Do okay for all the tables.
Yeah, now I've got this same screen.
Great. And Ms. Rajal, for you also, you can see it now?
Yes, I'm getting it. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So I click on the manage button. On the manage button, I will go on the right side. Now you can see the data here, right? Mr. Iqbal and Ms. Rajal, you can see all the tables once you click on the green button. Yeah.
Yes, Kushal, we can see. Great. At least I can see.
Thank you. Click on the diagram view on the right side. And it depends upon person to person, how you want to manage your data, how you want to see your data. My trainer told me to keep lookup on the top. And I think this is an important tip that he shared with me. And it's really helpful. Now, instead of doing the VLOOKUP, you would still have been thinking, Kushal, you're asking me that VLOOKUP is our enemy. Then what do we do? Now we need to create connections or relationships between different tables. You remember we spoke about primary key and secondary key, right? In customer lookup tables, you have primary keys which are unique. For an example, customer ID or store ID, the product ID, region ID, or even the date. These all are primary key which is appearing only once in the table. When you go to transaction 2018, these ID and the date could be repetitive. Same product could have been sold 10 times or things like that. How do we connect? We connect it by establishing a relationship. And how do we do that? Easiest way, just click on customer ID from the lookup table. And why I said keep lookup up and transaction, the dimension table on the top and fact table on the below, because you are going to create top-down relationship. One too many.
Kushal, how do I bring this transaction 18 down here? You can just drag and bring it down?
Yeah, just drag and drop anywhere. Yeah. Now, there are a few ways you can create a relationship. You just click on any table, right click and on the name and click on create relationship. And like that, you can create relationship. But let's do the easiest way first. Just pull this customer ID and drop on the customer ID of your transaction 2018. And that's it. The relationship is created. And you would see the arrow which says that it's flowing down, right? It's flowing from the lookup table to transaction 2018. There you will see the end of customer lookup, you will see 1. At the end of transaction 2018, you will see star, because this relationship is 1 too many. What is 1 too many? The customer ID in this table is only appearing once, but in the transaction 2018, it could be many times. If am I clear to explain this, or I need to explain again 1 too many relationship?
Clear so far.
If I may pause for 1 second, I didn't get one of the files. So is it possible to regenerate this, or I have to do everything again?
No, just you did not get means you have imported, but you're not seeing it here, right?
I have imported. Maybe I didn't do that connection. So yeah, I'm
just click connection. Just click on connection and add this to data model. You just close this window as it is here, and you go back to Excel, and then add that file to the data model.
Oh, okay, fine. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Michelle, for me, I'm having an issue where one of the transaction data files shows that it has got like 50,000 records or got some errors in it. So that's the reason that it's not showing up in that diagram.
There shouldn't be any error in such, Mr. Sachin, right?
Yes.
Yeah. There shouldn't be any error in such.
I think the column, the error is just like to, the error is probably is to do with some date column, I guess.
Actually, I'm also facing the same issue, but when I did this transform, I can see the table. Transaction 2018.
So you can see in the Power Query. So you did it again, Ms. Suvena, right?
Yes.
You but deleted still it then you.
Hmm. Yeah, it. I deleted and I'll try to import again, but still it is showing the 52,000 some errors. But when I see in the table, the one which you are showing the star sigma.
Yeah.
I can see that in that table, the transaction 2018.
Can you try to bring a transaction 2019 file, Ms. Suvena and Mr. Sachin? I'm not sure why there is an issue in 2018 file, but there is another file that I shared earlier, which is known as transaction 2019. Try to bring that file into the Power Query editor.
Okay.
And then we see if that is possible, then you can work on the transaction 2019 file. So going back to the data relationship, I'm moving on a little bit, Ms. Suvena and Mr. Sachin, because keeping everyone's time.
No, that's okay. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So we created a first relationship with customer ID to transaction 2018 by just dropping it down, and we can see one to many. We can also do another way now, just right click, create relationship, select the lookup table first. So let's say we click on store lookup. So from store lookup, you want to create connection to transaction 2018, and you would see it, this is store lookup, right? So you have a store ID here and you select store ID here. And that's it. You click OK. And the relationship, you can see one to many is established. Similarly, I prefer doing this way. So I just bring product ID to product ID, and you can create this relationship.
Kushal.
Yeah.
But when I clicked for that create relationship, and when I went to store lookup, it is showing only one column, means one box. The other table, it is not showing up.
Yeah. So you need to select a store lookup in the first, and in the second, you need to select transaction 2018.
Okay.
Always remember why I said always lookup table on the top. That means dimension table on the top, and your fact table, your data table on the bottom. So when you are selecting on the top, you select because the relationship you are establishing is one to many. Select store lookup on the top and transaction table on the bottom. Now it is working for you?
Yes. Thank you, Kushal.
You're welcome. So like this,
we are bothering you too much.
No worries.
KG students.
No worries. Please feel free. Now, here we see there is one important issue. Region ID, we are unable to connect because there is no region ID in transaction 2018. Oh, come on. I'm going to tell my boss that I cannot get the region data. Cannot, right? We cannot do this. What we can do here is to establish a relationship between other lookup tables. Where do we see region ID? Where we see region ID in the region lookup, and we see in the store lookup table. So let me bring this product table on the right side, and let me bring these two tables closer. And this is an important concept that we should understand. These two lookup tables, out of this one lookup table, we cannot connect to our data because there is no direct column which can create a relationship. So we are going to create a relationship between two lookup tables. And how do we create that? Don't forget our concept one to many. That means the region ID that is here in store lookup as well as in region lookup, where it would be unique. If you do not know, just go to data view. On the data view, go to region lookup and you would see the region ID is unique in the region lookup. But in store lookup, it is not unique. Region ID could be duplicated. I'm not seeing all the data here, but you could see it could be duplicated sometime because in the same region, there could be more than two or three shops, right? Or two or three stores. So you need to do one to many, bring one to the table menu. And like that, you create a relationship between two lookup tables. And that's when I said earlier, if you could not do this directly in the VLOOKUP, you would have to bring the store ID, the region ID to get this regional information. And that's what it makes very much easy for us to bring all the data like this. Now, for an example, you don't have this calendar lookup table at all. Let me delete this file. Okay, delete from model. Okay, I cannot delete it from here because it was created, but let me hide it. So for an example, I don't have it here. I'm going to delete this relationship. And let's assume you don't have this calendar table, but you want to see the timeline information. So an important topic here, go to home, go to data view. And it should be, yeah. So far you're with me. Can I move ahead? We are not using the calendar lookup table that we imported. Now on the Power Query, go to design. And you would see one table known as date table. You see that option? Click on date table and click on new. And boom, you will see all the calendar information that you can have for this date table. So Power Query also imports. You don't need to have a proper table. The Power Query can import all the information. As you can see, date, year, month, month number, month name, then week, Saturday, Sunday, all the information. Sorry. Are you with me so far?
Can we repeat this, Kushal?
Yeah, go to design tab and go to date table and click on new. And it will bring a new date table within the Excel, within the Power Query window.
Yes.
Now you would see that the year is starting from 1910, whereas our data is 2018 and 2019. Go to the same date table, click on update range. And I'm going to change it to 1st January 2018, because our data is 2018 and onward. So I'm going to select 1st January 2018 to 31st December 2019, and I will click OK. And like that, I have the data. Go back to home, go back to diagram view, and we will see this calendar table. Let me bring it into the screen. And now I can create this relationship between this date to transaction date, one to many. So far it's clear for everyone.
Kushal, this calendar has not changed for me, this calendar lookup.
No, it's okay. Calendar lookup, it's there, but we are not using it because I wanted to show you how you can build your own calendar within the Power Pivot.
Okay, so we just need to delete this connection from here right now.
It doesn't matter. If you want to remove, you can remove, or if you want to keep, it doesn't matter. And like this, we have created a relationship for the fact table with each of the dimension table. And we are not going to use VLOOKUP, right? So far, everyone is with me. I will close this Power Pivot window. And I want to show you with all those things we have done. You would see customer lookup table has 10,000 rows. Transaction 2018 is 86,000 rows. With all of this being brought in, the file, the size of my file is right click and go to properties. The size of my file is not even 2 MB. Okay, coming back. Now, what we need to do? What we wanted to do is, if I show you the file here, we wanted to see what is the store type, then member card, and then the regional cell in the columns. Let's do this. Go to insert, click on pivot table, and that's the important point here. Don't forget to use this workbook's data model. Again, go to insert, pivot table, and click on use this workbook's data model and click OK. On the right side, you will see all these lookup tables and the transactions table that we created. So far, everything is fine. Everyone is with me.
Sorry, can you repeat the last step?
Just insert a pivot table.
Kushal, actually, we are at the last table. I am at the last table that you did, right? The table that was showing. After that, what to do?
That means you are into Power Pivot window still, right?
Yes.
Yeah, just close the power. So you have done the relationship establishment in the diagram view. Okay, just close this Power Pivot window now.
Okay.
Now go to insert tab. In the insert tab, you can see pivot table.
Yes.
Click on pivot table and use, look at my screen, use this workbook's data model and then bring a pivot table. Okay, everyone is with me. We can see the tables on the right side.
Yes.
Okay, now we can start building. So we wanted to know the, let's say we have this store type, right? So open this store lookup table from the option and just bring the store type to the row. Pretty easy. On the region, let's bring what was the option we did there? This is the sales region, right? Sales region. So, yeah. So, I'm going to bring this sales region in the column and bring the quantity from the transaction 2018 sheet. Bring the quantity. Now, so far, everyone has done the steps until this. We have store type from the store table in the row. In the column, we have sales region from the region lookup. And in the values, we have quantity from the transaction 2018 or 2019 table.
Kushal, this the way you have, for you it is showing pivot table fields, it is not showing up in the similar way. Means I cannot drag anything from here.
So maybe you are seeing something like this. Something like this you are seeing, is it? If you click on the gear button, you have a few options how you can see the pivot table. So on the right side, you will see pivot table fields, the all the tables, and just make sure you are clicking on the all button, not on active button.
On all button, yes. But for me, it is the other way. The for you, two columns are there. For me, this was on the left hand side and the right hand side.
Yeah. I mean, that's a different way how you want to see. I mean, I can change it, but I prefer keeping it like this. So that's fine. As long as you can see the tables and you can see the filter, column, row, and value options, it's okay. And you need to open the file. You need to open the table and then bring the column to the respective field that you want to bring.
So from region lookup first we bring.
So from the region lookup, I have brought sales region to the column, and from the store lookup, I have brought store type to the rows, and from transaction 2018 file, I have brought quantity to the values. For Mr. Sachin and Ms. Suvarna, you are able to work with the transaction 2019 file, right? Or you are getting option issue error message there also?
No, I'm okay. I'm able to do till this stage.
Okay, great. And Mr. Sachin, you are as well?
From okay. Transaction, we are bringing quantity to the values, right?
Correct. You would see a pivot table appearing like this. And that's what we had done it without doing a lot of VLOOKUPs, etc. And if your data modeling, if you do once, it's there. I will show you a very important point here. If you ask me, Kushal, for an example, my customer list has changed. And now I have, for an example, if I open customer lookup file, and let's say you tell me, Kushal, now I have added 10 more customers in the customer CSV file, right? And let's say 10282, whatever number I write, and let's say the name is Kushal Arjaji. My address could be ABC Singapore, or okay, Singapore is here, and I'm married, I have a kid, and etc. etc. So I may have a lot of customers, or it could be that I'm adding more products into the product lookup files. I could be adding more regions, I could be adding more stores, everything. Whenever you do this, very easy, you would see on the right side, customer lookup is 10281 rows. On the right side, you will see the refresh button. Just click the refresh and you would see the 10282 rows. Whatever change I had done there is now already appearing in my Power Query, and it's real time. You don't need to change your file. In the same file, one source of information, you have added new columns and boom, you can see all the information here. I'll go to customer lookup and I'll show you my name. Okay, it's at the end. It's difficult to go to the end row. But yeah, you get my point, right? Now you can see one extra row with my name. And if I show you, for an example, customer lookup. I go to the pivot, and if I put customer lookup first name into the filter, you would be able to see my name there. Yeah, right? So it's again a real-time data. Whenever your base data changes, just refresh the data and you get everything all the real-time. And that's the power of Power Query and Power Pivot. And you can, there are a lot of different options. I will cover a few more. We have another 25 minutes. And I wanted to cover one more important topic with you, because when the flyer, you would have seen that we said MS Excel on steroids. You already see the capability, right? You are not doing anything. There is no VLOOKUP. Everything is in the Power Query window. You have done a few changes in your file. You have created different priority. For an example, if you want to see the customer priority we created, right? And you can see that customer priority option here. If you want low priority, opportunity and priority, that is the column we created. And whenever you add a new column or new dimension in your dimension data, like we did for Kushal Jaju, it will automatically insert the priority as per the conditional column that you had already set up. Before moving into the next topic, I wanted to cover one more thing here. A little bit technical, a little bit, because that would be using the DEX language, but we will do the simplest form of DEX language. Power Query, Power BI uses DEX language. The DEX is, I think, database expression or something like that. Sorry, I do not remember the full form, but there is a DEX language, database expression, something like that.
Data analytical exchange, I think.
Yeah, data analytical exchanges. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So the DEX language is used by Power Query and Power BI. We will see how. You would see the quantity are not in column. You don't want to send anyone things like it, because you would want to show some columns, some commas, etc. in the data, right? But it's a pain if you have to do it every time. So this is the first table. If you have to create another table, right? And if you create another table, for an example, you go to insert and you create another pivot table on the same file. And let's say you want to bring your customer ID here. I'm just creating one file, and then you want to bring the quantity here. And again, okay, let me bring where I see numbers in from the region, probably sales district. And you would see again, it is not into the comma format. And you don't want to change it every time, right? There's another important topic that we need to understand. Again, go to Power Pivot, and you will see one option as a measures. And if you are a power, if you are a fan of pivot tables, if you have worked on pivot tables, you would have knowing one feature which is known as calculated field. So the calculated field in pivot reports is the same for Power Pivot, which is known as measures. Click on new measures, table name, which table you want to create this measure. So let's say I want to create this measure in transaction 2018. What is going to be the measure name? Let's call it total quantity 2018. If you want to write description, let's say quantity in comma values. What is the formula we are going to use? We are going to use formula sum. Then it will show you all the columns from all the tables. You would see starting calendar table, date column, like that, customer lookup, quantity, product, everything. And we want to use the quantity from 2018 table, right? That is the column we want to use. And then close bracket. You can check the formula. It will tell you everything is okay. What is the formatting type? You may want it into number, use decimal separator, or if you want to use it into currency, or if you want to use into like percentage, if you go to number and you can select as a percentage, any type of formatting that you want to apply. If you want to have decimal places, you can select. And let's say for now, we just want US use 1000 separators, and the file is under transaction 2018, and click OK. You would see under transaction 2018, there's another column automatically calculated FX, which is a measure. You see the FX is same to what you see in the measures here. Now, you would see that this quantity is not into the comma, but if I bring this quantity, it's already into the pre-formatted. So once it may be percentage or it could be currency, etc., you need to set up once, and it's there for you to use anytime. Measures can be a lot of measures we can calculate here, but as of time, everyone is with me so far. Are you able, yes, to do this simple calculation of sum, right? What we have done is we have clicked on sum, and then we have selected the column from transaction 2018 table quantity, and we close the bracket. You can click on check formula. You would see no error under the category formatting options. You can select number, use 1000 separator, and that's it. Okay. Now it might happen.
Sorry, 1 minute. Why is this required? But what is the, like, why is it required, this measures function?
No, it depends. So this is a very simple example that we are seeing, right? For an example, you may want to calculate, let's say, average, or you want to see how many number of customers you have into Bellingham. There could be different types of measures you want to calculate. You may want to calculate.
Okay, the so just to sale. Analyze it further.
Exactly. Further analysis, if you want to do, you don't want to do all the data, all these analysis within, you don't want to, because it depends upon the filter you are using, right? If you want to see under this particular store, what is the maximum sales value? So for that, you can write a measure here saying transaction 2018, and you can say max. And what is the UUAN transaction 2018 quantity? Check formula, everything is okay. You may want to have a number with, let's say, 2 decimal place, click okay. Now I can add this again. to say I didn't write any name, but you can see the maximum quantity that I sold in Bellingham to any particular row is 3 or 5 or 6, between 2 to 3, 7, because there could be a lot of different customers whom I was selling, but the maximum quantity is 3. And like that, we can do mean, we can do average, a lot of different calculations we want to do. For an example, if you want to calculate year to date number, even that year to date, you can do by writing the year to date total YTD formula. By using total YTD, you can have a running total Jan, Feb. If you are using, if you are creating a table like Jan, Feb, March, April, May with the quantity sales, you can do the total YTD calculations as well. A lot of different columns. Make sense?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I got it. Thank you. Okay.
So this is one part that we had done. Another part I wanted to show you what you can do. For an example, now you have received 2019 file, 2019 sales file. So I go back to Power Query editor, and I can bring the 2019 file in the same query editor. So, and if I have applied, for an example, under transaction 2018, if I applied a lot of steps, let's say if I changed anything or if I added any new columns here, I can right click and duplicate. Let me show you something. So on the transaction date, let me add a column to say the month name. So you can select the transaction date, on the add column, go to date, and let's say name of the month. So you have inserted the month name. Similarly, let's say you want to add quarter, start of the quarter, for an example, when the quarter is starting. So basically for first quarter, it will show you 1st January 2018 and things like that. Suppose you need this data on all of your sales files. You do not want to do it every time. So just left click on the transaction 2018 and click on duplicate. It will generate a duplicate query, change the name to transaction 2019. Now, that is where a very important point. Go to the source on the right side, click on the gear box on the right side. Normal, how do we browse the files? Go to source, click on the setting button, and then go. You just need to select your transaction 2019 file here. Share files, transaction 2019, import. And click OK. The transaction 2019 file is in front of you. If you go to the last, you see all the options like 2019, all of those steps are already applied. You didn't do anything, right? You just imported a new file and everything is there. Makes life easier. Close and load too.
Again, yes, similar. It does.
Thank you. Close and load too. Similar, what you need to do is to take some time sometimes. So only create connection and add this data to the data model. I click OK and I get 2019 sales as well. Again, you know, one important point that we have to do, right? What one we did after importing all the files? Anyone recall? What did we do after we did this Power Query importing? What did we do after that?
Establish relationship.
Exactly. So we will need to establish relationship. For an example, if I bring a transaction 2019 quantity here, I will see an error. And you will see all the values are same. Because with transaction 2019, I have not created the relationship. So I will go to Power Pivot. I will go to Measures. And what we had done for transaction 2018, we will do for transaction 2019 also. Diagram view. And all those relationship we would do, for an example, customer ID to customer ID. I'm just doing this one because you get the idea, and then I can cover the next topic. And like that we do, and then we can get the transaction 2019 data. So let me bring one option from the customer, because that is where we created. So let me say customer country, and I need this comma measures, and then let's say transaction 2019 also, I want the quantity. And I can remove this measure. So you see, in 2018, the sales was only in USA. But in 2019, you had sales in Canada, Mexico, as well as Brazil. Now, suppose...
Kushal, sorry, to 2019, when you did this, how easily you can do... We switch over to the diagram view and then you lost there.
Yeah, you go to diagram view and then you also establish relationship with 2019 table.
Yes, we established, but again, the same way for each one of them, you have to do it.
Yeah, correct. Each one of you, each one of the columns you have to do. So customer ID have done, similar way you have to do for store ID.
Okay, clear.
So I'm not doing it now just to save the time in doing that, because you get the idea of what we are trying to achieve, right?
Yeah.
You create understood. Relationship yeah, for yeah. all of that, and then you can again do the slicing and dicing. Okay. Now, to answer Pratima as well, Pratima, for an example, you want to see what is the increase in any of the country on 2019 versus 2018, right? So that also you can create here. So let's say current year versus previous year. I can write the description what I want, and let's say sum of 20 sum of quantity from the 2019 quantity, right? Minus sum of quantity from 2018. I click on check formula. Everything is okay. I want it as a number, decimal number, thousand separator. I click OK. And now let me create this table again. And you would see in 2018 table, I got a new measure, current year versus previous year. Let me bring it here and you would see the results. The measure you have calculated, current year versus previous year, the results are there and you can use it. What is the growth? You can create the percentage, you know, what is the percentage of growth versus 2018 and 2019. Everything, all the kind of a number analysis you want to do, you can do it.
Right. Interesting.
Okay, now, this is one part. I also wanted to show you another part. I want to show you two more important topics. Number one, when I said Excel on steroids, why Excel on steroids? You would have already seen some of the things when we were doing this portion, right? It completely transforms the way we work with the tables. We no longer do the VLOOKUPs. We no longer use a lot of sheets and lot of VLOOKUPs with external ranges to get the pivot table we want to bring. We are not doing any of that, right? Another important point that is already on steroids, but what does steroid do? That allows you to do something which you're not capable of, right? That is what steroids do, if I can say so. The number of rows in this file, in any Google Sheet, sorry, any Excel file, is limited to 10 millions, right? 10 millions, right? The maximum number of rows are 10 millions. A lot of time it happens. So it's limited to 1 million now. I'm sorry. It's limited to 1 million. But sometimes it happens when we extract SAP data, the number of rows could be 2, 3, 4, 5, and even 10 millions. And that we cannot import into one sheet. But how do we analyze that? At that time, what would happen? You will have a lot of sheets with 1 million rows into each of the sheets. And you would probably spend the whole night burning the oil. Again, Power Query, very helpful. Go to data, get data, click on from file, from text and CSV. And you know, I shared one file with you, sample text file. Bring this sample text file into this new query, click import. This sample text file has about 4 million rows, or I think even more, I don't recall. You bring everything into Power Query and you would see here the delimiter is tab. It's a TXT file. The delimiter here is a tab. Just click on transform data. And just to show you, if I go here, transform statistics, count values. 2.2 million, right? So there are 2.2 million rows. In general, Excel file, you cannot use it into one, right? So again, this is why I say Excel on steroids. So close and load to create connection and add this data to the data model. Don't forget clicking on both the options. You get the data here. And if you're working with a startup, I'm sure you get a lot of data. For an example, for metadata, a lot of metadata. It could be SEO, Google search analysis, SEO analysis, or Facebook tracking, cost per tracking, a lot of information. And if you keep on adding, it's very difficult to work on that. You would see on the right side the number of rows that are being loaded. And again, you can do all the type of lookup relationship with the files that you have. If you have a few lookup files, you can do the lookup. It will take some time because a lot of rows. You can again establish relationships and then create pivot as we had done in 2018 and the previous example. Everyone is with me sleeping. Am I boring you or or you're with me?
No ways. You're not allowing us to yawn also. Forget sleeping.
And Kushal. Kushal, yeah. We'll wind up in 5 minutes time.
Just this point I wanted to show. And one more topic I wanted to cover if we have time. When we spoke earlier, a folder, right? You can bring complete folder into just one time. You remember we duplicated 2018 query to create 2019 linkup. But what if you have a lot of such files, like you have a file for every month, Jan, Feb, March, April, May, June, and it could be different years, January 2018 to December 2018. Then it could be 2019. Generally, you don't find this error in Power Query. It is just because I have a lot of Excel files open, so it's taking a little bit of more time. So in that case, what you can do, and that files keeps on adding, or it could be for different customers, right? You have customer one, customer two, customer three, and files keeps on adding. You don't want to create a new query. At that time, you can connect, rather than connecting it to a file, you can connect to a folder. And then all the files in the folder, whenever you put a file and refresh, you will see the data appearing in your Power Query.
Great.
On the right side, you see 2.2 million rows has been loaded. It will just take a few minutes.
We can see 2.2 million rows loaded, but after that, what we have to do?
There is some error message in my file. I think because a lot of Excel files are open. I don't want to click anywhere. Just wait for this error message, this processing to stop. We just have 5 more minutes maximum or 2 minutes. But I hope you get the idea of what I wanted to show you. Even if you have a lot of rows, which Excel generally in one sheet, you cannot fit in. You can bring it to Power Query, load it into Power Query. If you want to do any slicing and dicing based on to your data, if you want to include first name, last name to create a new column, or you want to insert another column, which is the month of your date, etc. Do all of that into that and then create connection and load data into your data model. And the same way you can work on creating pivot sheets or pivot charts or all of that, you can do what we were doing earlier. And that's why Excel is on steroids, because it can handle in one sheet the data of rows more than 1 million.
Kushal, just one question. If we want to get more data, so monthly, if we have more data which is coming in, so how do we just go and update all of those sheets? What do we do?
Yeah, so for an example, that file we had, transaction 2018 file, right? Let's say that is only January 2018 file. And now we have February, March, April, May, June data coming in. That's what you are referring to, Ms. Rajan, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So what you can do one way is on that original file, just keep on copying. Like what I did, I added my name into the customer lookup, right?
Right.
So that similar way in your transaction data also, in the month of February, you can copy paste February data, March data in all the rows. So you get all the file in your source data, and that will appear into Power Query once you refresh. That is one way of doing it. Another way of doing it, don't connect to an Excel file or CSV file, but connect to a folder. And then all the files in the folder will be brought in into Power Query automatically. If whenever you copy, like what you would do generally, you take data from the SAP, right? Just, or any of your accounting system, take data from SAP, copy that file into the folder where you have already linked the data, and that's it. You will see the data appearing in the Power Query and you can use the similar way.
Okay, thank you.
Question, if it is in a folder, then is it necessary that all the files to be in the same format?
Yes, that is important. So all the files should be into the same format. Good question. All the files should be in the same format. Because that's what you will do, right? Like you have all the month sales file. You will not put sales file and lookup file in the same folder and then bring that folder. You will not do that. Lookup tables would be separate, but similar files related to sales, you will put in there in one folder. My Excel is a bit...
Yeah, maybe.
Apologies, so yeah, we can... if any questions anyone has, or I think we can close on with this.
Yeah, and also I think because sometimes Excel, it happens when too many files are also open, and if the file is too big, it takes time also to download. So I think if there are any questions, Kushal has shared his contact. We will be sharing this presentation, Kushal, with them.
Yeah, I can share. No problem.
Okay. So if they have any questions or clarifications, they can ask you. Pavan?
Thank you, Kushal. And thank you, Kala, for bringing in Kushal. I think that this is the second presentation that I know of Kushal making it to the ECA members. Earlier, he has done it to the overseas chapters. Kushal, I must admire your passion towards Excel and the formulas, that you create. I could sense that when we were talking earlier today in the morning. And all through the session, you were very, very, very patient explaining each and everything. What I need to, apart from the takeaway of the learnings that you've given, there's another learning that at least I take from you, is that, the keenness of learning that you have, you guys probably may not know, Kushal is a self-trained. He has done courses and he does his own R&D. And applies it to the work that he's been involved into. But the other important part, I think, which draws a lot of kudos to him is in terms of sharing. He has been sharing it with everyone, and I believe that's the fantastic trait that you have, Kushal. So thank you so much for giving your 2 hours to us, and we members, we are very grateful, and we are making. And we're definitely going to make a very fantastic use of that. Thank you so much, Krishan.
Thanks, Pavan. Let me invite Anu to do the formal vote of thanks. Anu?
Hi, all of you. Kushal, it was an awesome session, excellent session. Excel is a blessing for a data-intensive critical function like a finance function. And I am really sure, we can't imagine a life of a CA without one. Such a powerful program with advanced tools like Power Pivot and Power Query was made to understand with much ease by our very own member, the Excel guru, I can call him, Kushalji, with his power-packed presentation. I take this opportunity to thank our speaker, Mr. Kushal, for his wonderful session and patiently resolving all the queries. I also thank the chapter committee and Kalaji for choosing such an interesting topic, just the need of the hour. Last but not the least, our dear members who have made this session much more interactive and a great success. Thank you so much, Kushal, and thank you all.
Thank you. Thanks, Anu.
Thank you. Thank you, Anu. Thank you,
Kalam. Thanks, Anu. Kushal, yes, yeah, we, you know, a lot of patiently you handle softly, very nice. It's also an inspiration to us. I think last year, who people who have attended in 2020 also you did for us, right? And to, as I mentioned in the beginning, Kushal keeps sharing about the Excel tips in the social media handles. Please keep following him. If you have any queries or clarification, you can always approach Kushal. Once again, thanks to all of you and wish you all a safe journey, safe travels. Be safe. Thank you. Happy vacation.
Thank you all.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. Good night.